Who's ready for our keynote today? DeLores has inspired thousands to be their absolute best. Her client list ranges from Fortune 500 companies to government agencies. Her story has been touted in publications from the Washington Post to Ebony Magazine, and she's a frequent media guest and has been interviewed on every major network, including Oprah and Entertainment Tonight. She's the author of Oh Yes You Can, Clean Out the Closets of Your Life, and Believe in the Power of You and Empower. She's also a contributing columnist for Smart Business Magazine. Guys, please give a big Texas welcome for DeLores Pressley!
Good morning! Are you happy? You're feeling it already out there. I love it. I love the energy. Give yourselves a round of applause. I will never forget my first trip to Las Vegas. I learned a very valuable lesson. If you've ever been to Las Vegas, how many people have been to Las Vegas? A lot of you, yes. If you've ever been there, I'm telling you, there is no place, and if you haven't been, there is absolutely no place like it. The bright lights, the chandeliers, the hustle, the bustle, the rich, the famous, beautiful fountains. It is an incredible city. My husband and I were there, and my husband leans over to me and he says, "Baby, I have a surprise for you." I was like, "Yes." Anyone been to that fashion show mall on the main boulevard? I'm thinking all of these amazing romantic things that he could do in Las Vegas. He could give me this amazing trip. Maybe he was going to have a horse and carriage ride down Las Vegas Boulevard. Or maybe he was going to have me go to a concert with Kenny Rogers. Anybody like him? Maybe he was singing, "Lady, I'm your knight in shining armor, and I love you. You have made me who I am, and I am yours." I could just see him taking us there, maybe to a front row concert with Pharrell. He's got some tickets, or a tennis bracelet. I just thought of all of these amazing, wonderful things that could happen in Las Vegas. You know what goes on in Las Vegas? So I knew he had this amazing surprise for me. He says, "Baby, you ready?" Yes, absolutely. He says, "I'm taking you to the rodeo." Ooh, all of those wonderful scenes that was in my mind just came to a halt. I was like, "You're kidding, baby, right?" He's like, "No." I was too thrilled. I was thinking, we've been married a long time, so I just couldn't hold myself. I said, "Grant, seriously? A rodeo in Las Vegas?" Yes. All right, so we ended up at the rodeo. After I had broke my nail, climbing on the bleachers, I had these blinged out white bling pants, smudges on them at a rodeo. So I sit down like this. You know how you do when your boss comes and you might go, and if he comes by or she comes by, you're like, "Hey." But not me, I was like this. So they start playing this song called the Rodeo Boogie. Rodeo Boogie? Could it get any worse, a song called Rodeo Boogie? But when they start playing the Rodeo Boogie, I was kind of liking the music. So while I'm sitting at my seat with my face like this, but they play the music, I was like. But when my husband would look, I'd be. I'm thinking, here I am with men with bandanas on. horses, just cows, all this stuff at our rodeo that I didn't want any part of. Then they bring the first bull rider out. Yeehaw, I love it. I'm in Texas, right? Did I forget where I am? They bring the first bull rider out. I'm starting to like it. But after all that fuss, closed arms, when you put your arms closed, you tell people you're cut off, and hopefully you're very careful about body language because it's very important. So they bring the second bull rider out. I jump on Rattle Cowboy, hold on, baby! Woo, that day I learned a serious, valuable lesson, and it is called Uncross Your Mental Arms. Uncross your mental arms. Actually, I learned two lessons. Don't wear open-toed shoes to a rodeo.